Welcome to Tazama at Four Points by Sheraton, Nairobi Airport. And I'm going to show you today one of very popular appetizers, which is very popular with our clients here. It's inspired from West Africa. It's called Suya beef skewer. And the ingredients for these are the mustard, paprika, a chili powder for the heat, ginger and garlic, pepper to taste, and peanut butter, which gives a lovely flavor once it gets roasted. I've got some cilantro and some salt. So let's start with the marination here. Some mustard, which already has some bit of salt, chili powder, paprika and chili powder. The food in West Africa is more spicy than what we eat here in Kenya. A bit of ginger and garlic, a bit of crushed pepper, not too much, and a generous dash of peanut butter. Give it a nice and gentle massage. And if you can see, I have not added salt to it because peanut butter also has salt and the mustard also has salt. So you've got to be really, really very easy on salt here. A bit of cilantro just for the flavor. So you're going to let it marinate for overnight, and the next day get some skewers which are soaked in water. And load the skewers because it's going to take a long time on the grill, because ideally it should be well done. And a bit of chewiness should be there. That's how they prefer it there. So you can make skewers like this. I've got a bit of head start here already. On a hot grill, we're gonna cook it slowly and till it gets nice charred up. You see? There is a nice shine and color due to the peanut butter. So while this is cooking, I'm going to move to another dish, which is called Malacca prawns. This dish is again inspired by the Southeast Asian flavors. As I was mentioned earlier, Tazama is an amalgamation of various flavors and influences which come into Africa, and this dish also is taken from southeast of Asia. Malacca is a strait between Thailand and Indonesia. So what we have got is a bit of curry paste, which is nice and fiery, and we will have some sugar added to this, which is going to give it a nice shine to the whole dish, and some chopped onion, some celery. I'm going to mix it up. Nicely. Remember, there is a bit of salt already in the curry paste here. And there goes our prawn. If you see, the food is pretty simple and clean. If you notice, I have not put oil in it. Usually people put oil, but I avoid it during the marination stage because that does not allow the marinade to seep into the meat. So this is how you're gonna marinate it. For seafood, you don't need to marinate it for too long. A half an hour marination will be good enough. I've already got some marinated, and I'll have them nicely placed on the grill. Try to choose the hottest parts of the grill when you're putting it. It avoids it from sticking together. As you can see, my skewers are done almost. So I'm going to move towards plating these dishes. This is again two very famous things here in Kenya. A tree tomato chutney and a mango and mint chutney here. And everyone is familiar with this thing, which is kachumbari, and we in India also make a version of it, which is more spicier. There you go. So on the grill, nice, and you can see the nice color. They are yet a bit underdone. So I'm going to flip them over, and you can see they are not sticking to the grill. So the secret is keep the grill hot when you're putting your meat. And they're curling up. So while the prawns are cooking on the grill, so we're going to prepare ourselves with plating. So we have garlic yogurt, mango mint, and the tree tomato chutney. In comes the salad. This time they have a beautiful, nice and crisp, freshly cut potatoes, chips. It takes a bit of time, but it's much tastier than